my friends, and welcome to the Weekly Roundup, where we discuss just a fraction of the insanity that takes place in the world each week. Our top story today, never-before-seen footage of the January 6th guided insurrection tour has been released, and it paints a very different picture than the one we've been sold by mainstream media for the past 2 years. The man who is now infamously known as the QAnon Shaman was caught on camera being peacefully led through the Capitol. Police showed him around and unlocked doors to inaccessible rooms. He was even captured praying to God and thanking the officers for their cooperation.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for giving the inspiration needed to these police officers to allow us in this building.
Proving once and for all that the biggest threat to a liberal is a man in a hat who works out, says please and thank you, and prays to God. Of course, a number of government officials have been quick to insist that you are in fact not seeing what you clearly just saw in that footage.
You literally can't believe the facts Tucker Carlson tells you. So say Fox's lawyers. Again, in Washington Post, most recently, just a day ago, Fox executive Hannity Carlson shows are not credible sources of news. And so to have said what he said when we saw Capitol police officers lose their lives, or police officers lose their lives, is just shameful.
Look at me. I'm your five senses now. Our girl KJP isn't the only one talking out of her ass this week. Jon Stewart apparently destroyed State Senator Nathan Dom in a recent interview where he used highly effective debate techniques such as, don't let the other guy speak.
Are you familiar with the 39-year-old woman in New Jersey?
I'm familiar with a ton of anecdotes.
Yeah.
I'm asking you a simple question.
This is not an anecdote.
When the police
actually happened,
go to a house.
She had a restraining order on her ex-boyfriend.
I can run through hundreds and hundreds of examples.
Ask questions you don't want answered.
If you don't have background checks, mm-hmm. and you don't have registration and permitting, how do you know who has a problem in terms of the people who you're giving a gun to?
Do you want to talk about the background checks first, or do you want to talk about solutions first?
I want to talk about what you're doing is you're bringing chaos to order.
Pretend to be outraged.
When it comes to children that have died, you don't give a flying fuck.
And my personal favorite, lie with statistics.
You want to ban drag show readings to children?
To minors, yes.
Is that free speech? Are you infringing on that performer's free speech?
They can continue to exercise their free speech, just not in front of a child.
Why?
Because the government does have a responsibility to protect.
I'm sorry?
The government does have a responsibility in certain instances to
protect
children.
What's the leading cause of death amongst children in this country? And I'm going to give you a hint. It's not drag show readings to children.
Correct, yes.
So what is it?
I'm presuming you're going to say it's firearms.
No, I'm not going to say it like it's an opinion. That's what it is.
Good one, John. Really clever. He really got him good, eh, guys? Except he didn't really, though, did he? I mean, obviously no one is suggesting that drag queens are reading stories to children and then finishing off the event by chopping their little heads off. But John's a really smart guy, so he knows that. What they're suggesting is that trans ideology is dangerous for a child's psyche. Honestly, why anyone would applaud a man who uses his intelligence to insult theirs is beyond me. So let's discuss how trans ideology leads to death using John's own whataboutism here. He's saying that gun violence is actually the number one cause of death in children. Therefore, we should focus on regulating guns before regulating drag queens. Seems fair enough, but have you ever wondered why gun violence is the number one cause of death in children in the US? Guns have been legal in the US since its inception, so why did we see a 30% increase in gun deaths in the year 2020? Well, let's just set aside what we all know took place in the beginning of 2020 and focus on the fact that Johnny missed an important little detail when spouting off his statistics about child mortality. The statistic he's referencing is for children aged 1 to 19 years old. Funny how 19 is a child when you have a point to prove, but it's a young adult when you're perusing OnlyFans. You know what I'm talking about, John. 90% of those kids who were shot were 13 to 19 years old in cities like Baltimore, St. Louis, New Orleans, and Detroit. There weren't a slew of 5-year-olds sleepwalking into their parents' gun cabinet and shooting themselves and their peers. What he's referring to is predominantly teenagers in gangs using illegal weapons. Now, John, I'm sure you would never argue that children who commit gang violence were simply born to be gang members. I imagine a smart guy like you would be more inclined to believe that bad behavior is influenced by culture. See, it's the same thing with drag queens. The trans community will incessantly point out that trans youth are the most suicidal demographic, but no child is born with the inherent desire to lop off their body parts. So why are we so hellbent on recruiting children into this death cult? Mark my words, in 10 years, when trans ideology has successfully created a generation of suicidal mutants, people like John will get up on their high horse and blame the catastrophe on a lack of rope regulation. The cat's out the bag, as over 100,000 WhatsApp messages from former British Health Secretary Matt Hancock were leaked to the press this week, where among other things, he was caught red-handed discussing the extermination of all cats at the beginning of the pandemic. Thank God they decided against that course of action and killed all of Britain's elderly instead. You'll like this next one. Ford has applied for a patent on a self-driving car that repossesses itself. I feel bad for the poor bastard who's gonna wake up one morning to find out his wife and his car left him. Let's just hope he's in Canada when it happens, where he can legally seek assisted suicide and be on cocaine when he does it. That's right, after BC decriminalized the possession of hard drugs last month, a cannabis company has been granted approval from Health Canada to produce and sell cocaine. Ebby told a news conference on Thursday about funding for overdose prevention and mental health that if Health Canada did in fact do this, the federal agency did so without engaging the BC government or notifying the province. It's not part of our provincial plan, he said, referring to the ongoing effort to stem the overdose death rate, with an average of more than 6 people dying every day in BC in 2022. Ah yes, I'm sure it was an honest mistake when you decriminalized drugs and then immediately approved production and distribution of drugs. Just like it was a mistake when you pumped all those black communities full of crack back in the 80s. Am I right? Oopsie! Speaking of black people on crack, yesterday I was aimlessly roaming the mall, as mothers of young children often do, and I came across Michelle Obama's new book titled The Light We Carry. I'm gonna read you guys an excerpt from the book where Michelle goes to Princeton University and realizes for the first time that America is a white majority country. There's something unnerving about moving through a place and not seeing people who look like you anywhere. It's haunting, almost as if your kind has been erased from the planet completely. You may have grown up knowing your grandparents, their food, their culture, their way of speaking, but now, suddenly, there's no history of them. Your own reality seems vanished. There are no faces like yours in the portraits lining the walls of classrooms and dining halls. The buildings you spend your days in are all named for white men. Your teachers aren't like you, your peers aren't like you. Even on the streets of the larger town, there's hardly anyone who looks like you. What honestly hadn't occurred to me before going to college was that there were giant pockets of America that looked less like where I came from and more like Princeton did. Basically, devoid of differentness. It took going to Princeton for the former First Lady to realize that a country with 75% white people and 13% black people has all white pockets. I'm gonna go ahead and guess her major wasn't in history, geography, statistics, or common sense. Can someone please tell me how this bitch got into Princeton in the first place? While we're on the topic of retards going to college, Columbia becomes the first Ivy League school to drop the SAT testing requirement, bringing us one step closer to realizing my dream of being the king of idiocracy.
Yeah, I know this place pretty good. I went to law school here.
Costco.
All right, guys, that's it for me today. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and check out some of these other videos from my channel. I will see you all next week for the next weekly roundup. Bye! When I was 12 years old, I went to Barbados. Could you imagine if I hopped off the plane and I was like, well, my friend, I'll be honest, it's not quite what I expected. There seems to be a lot of coloreds here.